Morning folks, welcome back to Betty's channel. She's doing the do as always. Please give us a thumbs up, give us a like, subscribe, drop a comment down below. Tell us what you all think, share with your friends. It's free to subscribe. There's no hidden costs or anything like that. Just click on that subscribe button, hit that like button so you get notifications of when a new video comes up. And watch out for great content. So, today, me and Chrissy Detects, she's about somewhere, are off to Staffordshire tonight. Because she's got a dig tomorrow with Middle Detecting Group, I think. Anyway, Staffordshire. And then we're going to North Wales, hoping to spend our first Christmas Eve and Christmas Day in Betty. Yippee! So we've decked her out with a bit of decoration. I'm not a fan of Christmas, as you all know. Dead. Christmas is dead. D-E-D. Disappointments, expectations and debts. That's all Christmas is to me, but anyway, it's not like me, is it? So, we'll have a good time. I'll film a bit of the road trip on the way down. There might be one or two videos, I'm not sure yet. But as ever, sponsored by the lovely Paul at £10 an hour. All manner of handyman services, DIY, does some solar panels, diesel heaters, split charge on camper vans, bit of wiring. He enjoys himself, so thanks very much, Paul. He sent us some beanies, which are available if anybody wants one, £15, including postage and packing. Send me a message on Instagram at £10 an hour. It's just basically at £10 an hour, and Paul will get back to you. See you in a bit. So, part of getting ready for a road trip is filling water tanks. Last time I did this, I pissed water all over the floor, so I'm much impressed about. But I'm now using the hose pipe, the flex hose pipe I've got, from the tap, straight into the container, and that saves unscrewing all the accoutrements and stuff. We've got, still got a bit of packing for doing the garage area, which is metal detector, waterproof and shit like that. I'm just running the engine for the charge batteries up a bit, because it's proper dim, but it is December, so you know, you can forgive the weather at this point in time. However, we have a problem. The problem I discovered this morning after several days of heavy rain and heavy wind is, from that screw there, there's been a slight leak. So I've put a towel, as you can see there's a damp patch. It's now stopped, so I've turned that towel over just to see if any more comes out. And if it doesn't, I've just, well, I'm gonna reseal it anyway on the roof, but there's nothing I can do for the next few days, so we'll just have to live with it, and hopefully it doesn't get any worse or it stops leaking altogether. But the best thing is, it's not on my side at bed, it's on Chrissy's. Hey! Boom, I'm staying dry. So we've had the bad news, let's have a look at the good news. After several days of heavy rain and wind, it's not leaked in. So, it looks like the go-faster spoiler has worked. I'm definitely going to get a new seal for that anyway, I might just buy the bullet and buy one. So we'll start shopping around for them. But yeah, the go faster spoiler seems to have worked. So, happy days. Right, that's us. We've packed the van, locked the house. We're on our way to Staffordshire for a weekend, well, three nights of first night in Christmas type of trip. Well, the first trip in Betty at Christmas.
It's the first time in 30 years.
That's
that
right.
I'm not going to be cooking.
Come on, talk to
the
camera. Talk to your fans.
Camera! Paul's fans. Betty's fans.
Thank you.
Sorry. It's the first time in 30 years, because my eldest is 30, that I'm not doing Christmas like with them, really. It's a bit depressing, really, but at the same time, I'm excited because of our adventure in Betty. But they've all got in-laws now, so it's alternative years. It's not what you're caught watching for.
Have you done?
Eh?
Have you done? Yeah. It's not all about you, you know.
Of course it is.
Anyway, we're south now to Staffordshire, because this one's got a dig tomorrow.
Yes!
I'll be doing something very different that I've never done in Betty before. And it's not what you think, lads! It's about food. I'm trying something tomorrow. So you just have to tune in and wait for what it is. But let me tell you, I've never done it in a van before, and I've never done it in a van I've built before. It's going to be nice.
Come on, let's hit the road before we get stuck in rush hour.
You heard her.
Come on.
Let's go. See you in a bit. Right, made it to our park up after several, well, not failed attempts, but it was very, very windy and very, very blowy and very, very wet.
We got to some high points.
Very high points.
By the time we got up there, it was like hoping to wake up in the morning. Some beautiful views, but it felt like Betty were going to tip over. It was that windy.
And it would have been dark anyway, because we were sitting off early.
I mean,
but, oh, hang on, hold the phone. What's that there?
It's a stocking.
It's a stocking. What does that mean?
It means it's Christmas.
And what are we doing?
We're spending Christmas in Betty.
Yeah, our first one ever. We've said all that anyway. Anyway, we're at Bailey's Caravan Site, Caravan Park in Congleton-ish, kind of like Stafford's kind of thing. Anyway, we decided to pay £15 a night, but we're only staying one night. It's got showers, it's got toilets, nice little site, a nice couple who run it, very friendly. So yeah, all the amenities you need.
Well, that's what we've got in here.
I'll just show the our fans.
Fans!
We've got nearly 400 subscribers. In fact, we've got 399. Come on, tell your mates. Get us to 10,000 so we can start work. Oh no, I don't work. She does, I don't. Right, I'll just show you around Betty. We've got some Christmas lights. Look at them. Cozy, and then look at that, we've got a little Christmas thing here. Lights continue around here. You've seen one stocking, there's the other stocking that'll get filled tomorrow. Little Christmas tree, little Christmas
gnome thing,
there, fairy thing in there. We've also got in the cab, well, you might not be able to see it though. There we are, it's a Christmas Grinch that our friends in America made. Trotting Fox Crochet. Oh, look at that! The booze corner! We've got the wine, and we've got the cider for the lady. We're going to have a good time, aren't we? Yeah?
Yeah.
Right. I'll not tell you what she did then. But it was funny. Right. Pick you back up in the morning, and I can't give you a tour of the farm because it's going to be dark. But again, like I said before, some exciting's happening tomorrow. Exciting! I'm going to do something I've never done before. Stay tuned. I had to put the diesel heater on because it's bloody nippy. Kettle's on for a cup of tea and a cup of coffee. Just use the facilities at the Bailey's campsite. It's basic, it's got toilet, it's got a shower. Not bad. I've been in. Good morning. It's Saturday morning, we survived the night. It was a bit stormy, a bit rainy, we've had no leaks. It's a bit nippy, so I'm going to put diesel heater on in a minute, but just having a brew with little cup causes that we got sent from America made by the lovely Trotting Fox. Megan, thank you very much. Go give her a shout on Instagram at Trotting Fox Creations or Facebook Megan Huntley, and I'll check out what she's capable of. She's very good indeed. We're going to get ready in a bit to go to a dig. But first, it's obviously breakfast. You know what that means, don't you? Check that out.
What are you doing, Paul?
Cooking breakfast. Cooking your breakfast.
Cooking my breakfast. You don't want yours yet, do you?
No, I am hungry yet.
What are you making me?
Bacon eggs.
Bacon eggs. Can you smell it? I can smell it. It smells great. Thanks, Paul.
I do a good Betty breakfast.
A good Betty breakfast. Thank you.
You're welcome, baby. Look at that for a Saturday morning breakfast. Very festive. Hey! Right, we made it to the dig. It's daylight now. Ashcombe Hall in Leek, Staffordshire. The hall's somewhere over there. They've got about 200 odd acres, so they're off. Hope they'll have a good day. And I'm not looking happy because I'll show you what happened this morning. Campsite were really nice, like I said this morning, cheap, cheerful, but it's turned out to be a bit of an expensive night because scraped a gate post, so I bet he's got a bit of damage to her, as you can see, but it's now that can't be fixed, and I'm glad she's not been painted yet because I'd have been absolutely mortified. So it's just another job to add to the list. it happens. Oh well. Now, here's the exciting thing that I promised you was coming in this video, and it is first time ever using a slow cooker, doing a beef casserole with a mashed potato later on with it. It's a 200 watt slow cooker, so there shouldn't be an issue with voltage. I'm going to plug it into that 240 volt socket there, set it on the bench seat, or I've actually set it on the floor, and we're going to see how we get on. Christine's out metal detecting, so I've got all day to cook it. Let's get cracking with the ingredients and see how we go. Beef's in, just doing mushrooms now, onions. I'm going to put some salt and pepper in it. I'm just boiling water to do the stock. I'm going to switch it on and leave it. See how we get on. Okay, that's the mushrooms, onions and steak, and beef steak in. Just waiting for it to kettle up a while so I can make a stock. I'll show you that. And that's the stocking. I've added a bit of gravy as well. Just a little bit of... It's all Aldi stuff, you know, so it's all dirt cheap. Let's just plug it in and leave it and see what the voltage drops to or not drops to. And if it works. If it doesn't, we're on chicken coma tonight. And there we are. Switched on. Cooking away. Hopefully this works. That's put it on floor for the time being. Move away from the dirty trainers. I need to sort out the food cupboard. I did say in a previous video that I'd be doing a Wi-Fi switch over, an upgrade to a Netgear. This is a Netgear M4, so it's still one of the early ones. got it cheap off a mate. I was using this ZTEC one previously, or ZTE one. That was £34 off Amazon. These are a bit dearer. Can't remember what they are brand new, but I think I paid 100 quid for it. That one was putting out 174 megabytes. This is putting out 650 from the same sim card, so I'll see how it goes over the next couple of days while we're away, and I'll report back. All right, so we've had a bit of a snag in using the van's inverter. Use a slow cooker. The voltage dropped to 11.9. now it's not sunny outside, so it's not getting much solar, and I could run the engine, but I don't really need to. So what I'm thinking is, it's on the EcoFlow River 2 Pro power bank, and it's been on 20 minutes. It's just dropped 3%. It's only drawing 113 watts. That says 113. So it's not been too bad. And it says it's got 4 hours left of power. That might change when I have to do toasties in it. But it's cooking it. So I think in terms of the van, I might have to upgrade to lithium batteries. So if anybody out there in YouTube land has got some spare lithium batteries that I could have for not very much money, I'll have them off you. I might also have to upgrade the inverter, because the inverter, even though it's a 3,500 watt inverter, or peaks at 3,500, it was 300 odd quid, and it's an Edorcia. I think, which is supposed to be a good make. Bit disappointed that it's not handling a 200 watt slow cooker, but it might not be the inverter, it might just be the batteries, because they're what, 12 months old now. They're brand new, and they're AGM batteries, 115 amp hours. So I think it's probably the batteries more than the inverter, to be fair. So yeah, plea. I'm having a plea. I'm sending a plea out there to anybody who wants to donate some lithium batteries, or wants to sell them quite cheap, I'll have them off you. Thank you very much. Alright, so we're just doing some cheese and toasters in the little sandwich maker. Voltage has dropped down to 80, and it's drawing 795 watts, which is probably exceeding the power bank, because I think the power bank's 750. Might be wrong. But as soon as these are done, I'll take them off. And that should ease the power outage, voltage, usage, somewhat. And the wattage has now dropped to 113 again, so obviously this is when the sandwich toaster is just chilling, basically. because the green light's on. And when the green light goes off, it might just... Well, no, when the green light comes on, it's warming up again, basically. I think with sandwich toasters, it's warming up, and then when that goes off, it's heating it, but it's just warming it, if that makes sense. Yeah, that makes sense to me, because I'm on Bell End. Right, we've just left Ashcombe Hall in Lake Staffordshire, and we're on our way. We're heading towards Llandudno, in that there, North Wales. Isn't that right, that there, Chrissy Detects?
That sure is there, that right. It is, my lover.
So, we're going to do a bit of footage on journey. But it's been a good day, actually, today. Weather's been all right.
Good day.
And obviously, you've just seen the old beef casserole being cooked, which we're going to have when we park up, after we've boiled the spuds. Isn't that right, Chrissy Detects?
That there is right, that there, Mr. Jay.
So, we'll see when we get there. Swans in it, and it's looking. Can you see me? I don't think you can. There's my head. Can you see me now? You can see my ears. Anyway, got some tea and a bit of wine, and we'll see you in the morning. Put the potatoes on to make mashed potatoes. That's warming up nicely from this afternoon, and the river flow 2 is down to 19%, but remember I've done two toasters with that, so that's all good. I still think I could have done them with the van electrics, but because I've had no sun and I've not been running engine, I mean we're at 12.9 now, so I could have probably carried on doing it. And that's the mash done. We didn't have a masher. I've used that wooden spatula. It's alright. Look, it even stands up in it. Look at that. Cool. Look at that. Two beef casseroles and mashed potato. Done in Betty. Proper proud of myself. And now, it's 1 o'clock. Morning, folks. Well, we had a cracking night's sleep last night in this Ace Park up at Colwyn Bay. It was a bit windy and it was a bit rainy, but it didn't really disturb us that much. So today, after breakfast, we're going to drive down to Llandudno, see if we can park. Well, we can park up because we can park during the day, but we can't park overnight. That's why we ended up in Colwyn Bay last night. So we're going to have a wander around Llandudno, see what's what. And then tonight, we're off to Prestatyn. Going to hopefully get a park up near a beach or on the beach, whichever, we don't know yet. And then we're going to have our last night. Well, it's Christmas Eve today, so we're going to have our last Christmas Eve park up. Not last Christmas Eve ever, because that sounds like the last supper, do you know what I mean?
Sense,
what I mean is...
I don't know what you're talking about.
What I mean is, we're going to drive to Prestatyn later, park up, and that's our last night of the trip. Tomorrow's Christmas Day, so we're going to have Christmas in Betty. Come along and enjoy it with us, because we're going to wish you all a happy Christmas. We've just hit 400 subscribers.
Yay!
which is great. Just need that extra push to get to 10,000. So, you know, we can start earning money from YouTube. Because the content is this. You all love it. There's millions of people that just haven't seen it yet. Because it's not been shared, so you need to all share it. There's like millions of people out there that will hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and we'll be millionaires next year, Rodney. What can you say?
Yeah,
right, I'm not going to film the breakfast because you saw it yesterday or earlier in the video. Just bacon and eggs. So, you know, the usual van life
same
breakfast.
As.
Same as. But tonight we're on chicken korma for tea, which I might film because I filmed the teas that we've had. You know, I filmed the... oh no, we had chips on Friday night. Beef casserole last night and it's chicken korma tonight. So, we'll see you in a bit. Right, we just pulled up in Llandudno and you can see what the weather's like, how windy it is. So we're staying in van for a bit and then we might have a wander. I'll come back to you in a bit. Town centre, and there's the sea. That view from Main Street. I don't know if that's a great home or not, but yeah, it's nice, quite busy as well. Hiya. Bit of a disaster.
Wow, what's happened?
Open back door, wind blew it right round.
Blew what right round?
Back door.
Oh my god.
So I couldn't shut it, so I ended up snapping the check strap.
Yeah.
It's all fixable, but it's shut. Then I forgot to put the salad in the fridge.
Yeah.
And I got to B&Q, but I realised the time I'd not put the things in the fridge.
Okay.
That's what back. Van life!
So we've got a scar on Betty that's a scratch.
Yeah.
From scratching.
There's a dint in back door as well,
now. There's a dint in. Oh my god, Betty's got to get him put through the mill for Christmas, isn't she?
Great.
Maybe right. I like your calm, smooth, like,
right.
Inside, about your like,
yeah. No,
cracking
no.
Up. Because
if it had a nice paint job, I'd be sat here quiet behind it right now. You see me like that. I can't afford to go to TK Maxx. I can't even afford to go to Aldi. I'm going to TK Maxx. Why to an end, he's just no good at all. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Go on.
Let's go shopping.
See you later. Special.
Fish and chips for dinner at the Trinity Square Cafe in Llandudno. That will fit. Right, we're just leaving Llandudno now. We're on our way to Prestatyn for our last night of the trip. What do you reckon, Chris, did he text?
Yeah, man.
That it? Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
That's it. Not excited, because you might be metal detected on Christmas Day.
Yeah, man.
On the beach.
Yeah.
Right, we'll film a bit of the trip from Llandudno to Prestatyn, and we'll see you very soon. Say ta-da, Chrissy.
Ta-da, Chrissy.
Beach in Prestatyn was a washout, not literally. No overnight parking for camper vans. What can you do? Let's go find somewhere else, that's what we do.
The joys of wild camping.
What is it?
The joys of wild camping.
What is it?
Shit!
This is a park up we came to last night. Because we can't park in Prestatyn, Towin, Rill, Tallaght Beach, because there's an overnight parking or high barriers.
Wales, you're letting the side down.
Yeah, Wales, you're letting the side down, mate. So coming back to this one that we were at last night. If I can find the entrance. Anyway, this is what it looked like last night when it was dark. Same place?
Yeah.
That's that lake I was on about, and you just see the swans there. There we go. Right, so like we just said, we're back at the same park up as we were last night in Colwyn Bay. The whole campervan motorhome parking issue in Wales has got really, really bad. And for some reason, it's Christmas Eve, there's no one about. So I don't understand why you're not allowed to park.
You'd think they'd like raise the restrictions at this time of year when it's not that busy.
Out of season especially. Yeah, out of season especially.
Yeah, I get restrictions, but there is too many restrictions at like the height of like the season. But when it's dead like this.
Wales, you're losing out on a shitload of money from us camper van lifers people visiting touristy thingies.
Because there's a big chunk of us out there that are tidy.
Mass, there's loads!
They don't leave a mess.
Yeah. We take all our shit with us. Leave no trace.
Respect the land.
Yep. Leave no trace. So, the whole trip hasn't... This is not busted the whole trip because the whole trip's been ace so far, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So we're still enjoying ourselves. We're having a good time. Like I said, it's Christmas Eve. It's just gone...
It don't matter, as long as we're with each other at end of the day.
We need to be together. So, it's just the whole parking thing's a bit of a disappointment, but... And then you get something like this that I've just shown you with that lake and the geese and swans, and not geese, swans. I don't know me birds.
I've gone quackers.
Anyway, and this park up's ace, it's quiet. It's you know, it's fairly security.
There's cameras everywhere.
Cameras everywhere. And we've just been down to the beach, down to the promenade front, and there's actually signs that say caravans and motor caravans, 11 p.m. till 8 a.m. So, in theory, you could park, but you don't know if the word no has been scratched off or painted over.
No.
And we don't want to get done. And then we read on one review where some guy got his van vandalised by...
Stoned.
Not in a good way, not in a... You know what it is, man? You know what it is? I'm getting stoned! Someone's just thrown a rock at me van. That kind of thing. We don't want that for Betty. She's had enough damage on this trip.
Gotcha.
Let me tell you about what happened earlier on. Anyway, parked up in Llandudno. Brought the shopping back to the van. Opened the back door. Bell end here. Didn't realise it was really, really windy. Caught the back door. Flipped the back door end onto the side of the van. Because on vans you can open them like all the way around, so obviously you get more cargo in and whatever. And wind ripped it round, bent the check strap, and I couldn't shut the door, so I've had to snap the check strap to get the door shut and secure, and it's damaged the door slightly. So on this trip, we've had the scrape down the side that you've seen, we've had the damaged back door and snapped check strap, can't open the passenger door from outside. Because the handle's fucked. So there's a long list of jobs that need doing on Betty when we get back.
We still love her though.
Like I said before, and you'll have seen the video that Chrissy took of me outside TK Maxx crying. If it had been painted, I'd have been gutted. Absolutely gutted that I'd done this damage. Because it's my own fault. I'm a bell end. I'm an absolute bell end. So it's my own fault. But because she's not been painted yet...
It can be fixed.
I'm not as gutted as I would have been.
She'll look even more beautiful when she's painted.
She will. I mean, I'm beautiful now because I've had my hair cut again. Christine's beautiful. Chrissy Detect is beautiful.
What do you want?
I need a wee.
Oh, I thought you were after something.
No, I don't need to smooth you up for stuff like that, baby. So anyway, we're going to get into the back of the van. Hey, you know what I'm saying? This van's rocking, it's the wind blowing it. And get settled down for the night. Get on some tunes. Have a bit of wine. Chicken korma. Do you know what? I said earlier I was going to film it, but I can't be arsed, to be honest. I'm not going to film the chicken korma. You've seen it before. I've done it loads of times in loads of videos.
That's it.
That's it.
Happy days. Keep smiling. Keep smiling. Yep.
Right, anyway, we'll see you in a bit. We might even see you at morning. Give you a Christmas message because it's Christmas Day tomorrow. Still not decided whether this is going to be one long video because it is going to be a long video. And if you've actually got to this point and it's one video, you're ace. Well done.
Fam bloody tastic.
Yeah, you'll be glad it's all over, let me tell you. But anyway, you're still going to subscribe, share with your mates because you were going to get us up to 10k, 10,000 subscribers. I know you are. I've got faith in you. And I'm watching you. Yeah. Right, we'll see you in a bit. Say ta-ra, Chrissy. I did say I wasn't going to film a korma, but I am now. Coming together nicely. White rice, chicken korma. We've got poppadoms and mango chutney as well. Is this not the best Christmas tea ever? Look at that, chicken korma.
Boom.
Right, we've got little stocking each. These are our silly presents. We just said we'd buy some stupid to put in these stockings just for the giggle. They
got very stupid ones.
Stupid presents. It's half five in morning.
These masking tape because I couldn't find sellotape.
And it's full of masking tape.
I couldn't find sellotape.
Very typical Paul style. Masking tape on presents. I don't need it ass. Got loads of sellotape at home. What have you wrapped to me? Oh.
It's a prop.
What was it? That what? You're very puzzled, aren't you? It's a prop.
I think it's a croc air freshener.
Yay! Why croc?
Because I love crocs.
Love crocs.
Crocs make us the man.
Crocs. You wear crocs and socks, don't you?
Crocs and socks make us the man.
God, I can't open this.
That's all right.
I can't open it.
What is it? Just a piece of wrapped paper?
Yeah. I'm scared of spending all that money on you. You know, your belly?
Yeah.
I've just got to give you some paper.
Jesus Christ. Paul bought me some expensive wellies.
And a bag.
He's bought me a bag.
Some boots.
And he's got me some nice fashion boots. Boots. And a pen. That says... Can't see.
I'm going to read to you.
What does it say?
It says, the hardest part of my job is being nice to stupid people.
Stupid is, stupid does.
Stupid is, stupid does.
Stupid.
Stupid. She calls me Forrest Gump sometimes, you know.
I think I forgot to check it. Let's see what else is in this little stupid stocking. Poster saying, what day is it? Asked Boo. It is Monday, said Piglet. Fuck, said Pooh.
And I've got Shart wipes.
Shart wipes. Let's get closer to the camera.
Shart wipes. Which is probably very good for me.
Shart wipes and Crocs. I'm going to put three in. Oh, I've got four in mine. I'm going to put three in yours.
All right. If there's kids watching this,
stick it out. It's not a stocking. What is it, Paul? What is it?
As I said, if there's any kids watching this, turn away now.
What is it?
It's a willy warmer.
Willy warmer! Isn't it cute?
She does exaggerate a bit. Wishful thinking for me. Thanks, babe.
You're going to style it for me after?
Do you think I should style it after and we'll put it on camera? Yeah, we'll do that. We'll show you how it fits later.
Yeah, I'll be all shriveled up, won't bend.
You talk about the sock?
Yeah.
You see what I put up with?
Oh my days. Does that look all cute? Is it a key ring?
Do you not read what it says?
Yeah, I'm in the corner. I'm in the dark here.
You've got a light above your head, you know that, don't you?
Yeah, I know. It's too early to put a light on.
The keyring says, it's got a little heart on it, it says, I hope your day is as nice as your butt.
Oh. Nice butt. I've got one more left in my stocking. Silly. Silly gift.
Is this your video?
Huh?
It's your video.
No, it's you.
It's me?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
A pet rock. Pet
get,
rock.
Get a copyright of it music.
Huh?
Get a copyright of it music.
It's alright.
What?
It's alright. Oh, look at that. Pet rock. Was it fair?
Your pet rock needs lots of love and attention. He slash she slash they slash it should be walked for at least 30 minutes every day. Do not take your rock off the lead when walking, as they are prone to running away.
My pet rock name's called Alan.
Alan!
Ow!
Al!
Ow!
Alan.
Meet Alan.
Alan, you're right, Alan?
Yeah. Yeah. My new pet.
Yeah.
Aww. Alright, Alan. Go back to bed now. It's still a bit early, isn't it?
I want to get copyrighted.
Well, it doesn't stop you from having the video, does
no,
it?
No.
Right, so that's our silly stockings. We've got some more presents to open up, but yeah, we just wanted to do our silly stockings.
Yeah.
That was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah. So, what we're going to do, we're going to end this video here. It's a long one, and like I said last night, if you've got this far, you're ace. Absolutely ace. Thank you very much, Cockhead. Thank you very much for watching Betty's channel over the last, 12 months. You've been going about three years now, Betty's channel, and we have 8,400 subscribers. And hopefully, like I said, with an extra push, get us 10,000. So, as ever, I'll tell you what, now, let's wish you all a Merry Christmas.
Have we a thing?
Yeah. 3, 2, 1. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And we'll not do any more of the chorus. So, again, thanks for watching. Thanks for putting up with us. Thanks for following us. We appreciate each and every one of you. And for those who don't know us, you're missing out on a hell of a lot on this channel. So So like I said, it's been a long video, it's been a long journey, but thanks for watching, we appreciate it. I might stick a bit of bonus footage at the end yet, I don't know. And this is van life in Betty. First Christmas in Betty, and it's been ace, hasn't it?
It's been fabulous.
Apart from the crap parking in Wales.
Yeah.
It's been ace. Even the weather's not put us off.
And the scratch on the van.
Well, yeah, the damage to the van.
And
but,
the dent
on
the door.
Yeah, but,
it's Christmas.
It's Christmas, so, you know. Right, we'll wish you again happy Christmas, a wonderful new year. Take care of yourself, look after yourself. Don't do anything that I wouldn't do. Or don't do anything that Chrissy wouldn't do. See what I did then. Right, and we'll see you in 20... Actually, we might see you before 2024, because I might have to do another video on all damage I've got to repair. So, after three, keep doing... What you do? It's a wrap.
Okay.
Can you send me that?